everybody. It is Brooke. I am back. Today we are back to watching Angel. We're on season 1, episode 11. If you would like to watch my uncut reaction to this episode, any of the previous Buffyverse episodes, or the next two episodes in the lineup, you can do so on Patreon, which is linked in the description. I have a $2 tier for early access to the edited reactions, and then a $5 tier for access to uncuts, as well as a bonus show that's just for the patrons. And I'm very excited, so thank you to my patrons if you're watching this uncut. Hello. If you're not, please make sure that you like and comment on the YouTube video and subscribe if you haven't. I think 40% of the people who watch these videos are subscribed, but that means there's a bunch of you who still could. It's fun, especially for smaller channels, if you guys subscribe, because we unlock like options at certain levels. So I unlock like the streaming option stuff at 500, and I want to do some like just fun live streams and chat with you guys. I think that could be really cool. Other than that, I'm really excited for today's episode. We just had a run of 3 Buffys in a row, and a lot was going on there. They're dealing with some apocalypse stuff that I think is related to this apocalypse stuff we're kind of dealing with in this video, this show in general. Last time on Angel, I've accepted that Doyle is dead. It hasn't gone up yet, so I don't know what happened. I decided not to look it up because I didn't want to get any spoilers. So I'm waiting till those videos go up, and then I'm sure either my patrons or you guys on YouTube will let me know what went on with the actor who played Doyle. Because, yeah, I don't know why he left. Him and Seth Green left the two shows around the same time, so I thought that was kind of strange. But Wesley's back. Not someone I ever even thought to ask to come back, but he was kind of funny in the last episode that we watched. We couldn't see his face, right? So they kept saying, like, somebody was following this guy, and they wouldn't show us the face. And I'm like, well, it has to be someone we know, because there's no point in, like, hiding the face if we don't know the person. And I was like, who could this be? And he did not even come to mind, I'm gonna be honest. But it was interesting to see him, and then he changed back into, like, a suit. My man's gonna find, like, a middle ground on the fashion there. But I think he's sticking around. He stuck around to eat at the end of the last episode, which makes me think maybe he's replacing Doyle. For my faves, Angel and Cordy. Cordy has Doyle's visions now. She's not happy about it at all. She thought because he kissed her in the episode that he died, that that's how you pass the powers on. So she spent the last episode kissing everybody, before she was kidnapped by a demon and almost sold to the evil corporation. Well, she was sold to them, but then Angel and Wesley showed up and they saved her. I'm excited. We kind of have a feeling something bad is coming. I don't know if it'll take the two shows coming together to stop it, maybe near the end. But we're about to see more of what's happening in LA, because we know in Sunnydale right now, they were just dealing with some earthquake demons and the Hellmouth, and Riley is, they found out he's a part of the commandos over there, if you're not watching the Buffys. Buffy has definitely, it feels like, moved on more than Angel has. I think he's held back a little by remembering that day. We haven't seen Kate in a while, who I assume is his love interest in this show. I don't ship it super hard, at least not yet. Maybe it'll grow on me. But I'm excited to see where it goes. I think this show has a little less, like, romance-y shipping plots. Like, Cordy and Doyle kind of is the background one. But because it's more focused on, like, the true crime-y, not true, but, like, crime drama-y, vibes compared to the high school vibes maybe over on Buffy. But I'm excited. Let us dive in to today's episode. No thank you, weird finger guy. It's not Angel, is it? It just has brown hair. But it kind of looks like him in the stature. Oh no, this can't be good. Oh, it's Kate. I was just talking about you. Okay, maybe he's like psychically connected to the vampire that's doing this?
Where? It's the same guy. This makes three.
Serial killer.
Just getting started.
Serial killer vampire.
It's the city of dreams.
Sorry, Cordy, I got to pause to talk to my YouTube viewers about the new opening. If you'd like to see my live reaction to the openings, those are on the uncuts. But, okay, no Doyle at all in the opening, not even in, like, flash scenes that I noticed. Wesley is fully in the opening, so I think that does mean he's a main. And I was kind of thinking, it wouldn't be too hard for them, really, because it's not like they have to refilm the trailers. They use, like, scenes from the show that are refilmed. So versus like, you know, a show that like does these insane credits and then they would have to change them, which would be kind of annoying. But yeah, he seems like he's gonna be here for the long haul, at least for now.
A mystical oasis.
I think it's about to speak.
Nobody likes a smart ass rogue demon hunter.
They still call him that?
Just thought I'd pop round so we might compare battle plans.
My man is wearing a linen suit.
Precisely. Right. Well, everything seems quiet.
He's got zilch, zada, nothing.
Well, thanks for stopping by.
Belt. Vanquishing that empathy demon in such short order.
Right. I thought maybe you could have policewoman run it for us on the QT.
Kate.
Are you sure you're okay? I mean, for a guy who's 200 plus.
Yeah, you're being kind of snappy.
With the bags.
Why are you being weird? That was weirdo behavior, Wesley.
No rush. Late afternoon. Evening will be fine, actually.
Didn't they say we're working on a kidnapping case? I feel like there should be some rush.
Even for a minute.
Tough one.
My first victim, Reggie Sparks, volunteered as a crossing guard.
It's obviously not him.
I've spent the last 48 hours putting together a suspect profile. And believe me, being inside this guy's head hasn't been a whole lot of fun. Time.
Now he thinks he's a serial killer.
White male. To the observer, he will not seem a monster. His victims put up little or no struggle, so it's likely he's charming, attractive, but at his core, he's a loner. We look for a precipitating event in cases such as this, and a painful breakup is always at the top of our list. Prior to failing, this relationship may have marked an inaccurate...
It is interesting, though, because you think if it was based... This is literally from nothing. This is from watching too much Criminal Minds. But you'd think if the trigger was a broken relationship, like, he would be targeting women that remind him of that broken relationship in like an unsub as the word they use way. Like, you would think, like, if it was the brown-haired curly girl, maybe it's women, but like the pattern, he's not sticking to a gender or an age group or anything like that, which is interesting. Like, you think if it was Angel's Angelus subconscious or something, like, he would be targeting women that look like Buffy or something.
Like, he would have regarded it as a lifeline.
My man, what the fuck?
Where is he? Where's Angel?
Not here. What is that?
She's like, you're not staking my man.
Rude coming into a vampire.
He's my boss.
Business with one of those things, don't you think? I'm against it.
Die from the fear I feed on them.
Okay, so you've been having nightmares. It doesn't mean you.
They're not nightmares. I've enjoyed them.
Oh, you? Live your life.
And you fear these might be more than just dreams, that you're acting them out in some sort of hypnagogic state.
Like I need instructions from you. A glamorous LA life. I get to make the coffee and chain the boss to the bed. Gotta join a union.
Cordelia, I think that's tight enough.
And if it turns out that we're back on the liquid lunch, better safe than cocktails.
Oh, the olden days. I thought this was now. I was like, the fuck's she wearing, bro? That's like, unless this bitch is at like Plymouth Plantation.
Not better.
Okay, that was old dream. He's still locked up.
Wiki.
We made it.
Great news, sports fans. There's been another killing.
Oh, so it wasn't you.
Not so great news.
Better.
Who the fuck are you?
First kill. Does she feel nothing?
So no. He had an apprentice.
I feel hungry.
You do learn quickly.
And my father would disagree. They'll all be sitting down to dinner now.
Feast. Excellent. When they invite you in, savor it, Pen. You'll not recapture the moment.
Okay, I think Pen might be mad at you about something. My man, with that haircut, I'd suspect him immediately.
And this dude hasn't lasted 2 centuries. Why do you think he's still doing the same old shtick?
Well, stake him.
Classic, isn't it?
Cordy's like, you're all crazy.
That watermelon with a sledgehammer. That might explain the dreams.
No, I used to have a connection with those I sired. It just means he's close, that's all.
Neat. We can't find him, and the cops stand zero chance of actually stopping him.
None of your business.
You can't walk into a police precinct with intimate knowledge of these murders and claim a 200-year...
Yeah, she already did think you were a serial killer that one time.
You'd be locked up faster than Lady Hamilton's virtue.
Or good for us.
You think she would think he's a serial killer again after falsely accusing him last time? Thanks.
Angela, are you okay? You're not that the brooding man of mystery.
Are we gonna tell her we're a vampire?
I mean, it is a lot.
Can we talk somewhere in private?
Yes, I trust you.
His next victim will be a white male.
How are they gonna cover every liquor store or whatever?
Well, we'll just have to see that doesn't happen.
Exactly. Once you hook this up, she finds something, we'll know about it.
Where'd you get the police radio?
Police car.
Oh,
I took it.
So let's add patrols here and here.
All right, we'll set it up.
Anything matching the profile gets reported.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Mitchell, you gonna ride with me?
Ma'am, could you possibly pick me up some beer?
She's like, kid, I'm not buying you beer. That's illegal. I would be breaking up any kids I saw outside of liquor stores and being like, no. Stop him.
I was over here.
You know, you remind me of a brother that I once had.
Yeah, whatever. I think we're going nowhere here.
We saw you biting him. He got interrupted. I'd be like, did you see that?
I'm going in.
Okay, be careful. Alright, we have park a little closer. I feel like Kate might find out about vampires this episode. I could see that. Because we're probably going to need her resources for what's to come.
Do not move, I will fire!
Angel, hurry up! That's what he wanted.
Ouch.
I came through the roof.
Jealous?
My God, it's been a lifetime.
At least.
We were to meet in Italy, remember?
I remember.
No, well, you've got crazy
Hell,
eyes.
I waited till the 19th century.
That's not why I'm here.
Request assistance. Suspect sighted second floor southwest.
Yeah, why are you here?
To kill you.
Angel! This scrawny guy's kicking your ass! Stab him!
Go ahead, get out of here!
Alex explain it later, but I has guts to go after that guy.
And he got up. If I pull this trigger, are you gonna get up too?
Yes.
What are you?
You already know the answer, Kate. The victims have all been drained of their blood, haven't they?
And should I trust you more or less because you happen to know that?
You're not gonna stop.
Now you saw me fight that other guy to save you, okay?
Direct sunlight, decapitation.
I've heard enough.
No, you haven't heard a word. And you won't. Not now. Not yet.
Yeah, he can't fake that.
In this world you're just not ready to face.
Here's everything with that MO, dating back as far as I could find.
Well, you've come to the right place.
Here she's still practicing.
We won't judge, but we will charge. Now, if you only tell me how you heard of us.
From the police, actually.
Really?
He needs to go. Cordy needs to not be here.
Is it cold out there?
I'm trying to remember her name. What was it? She's about yay tall, attractive, natural blonde.
Oh yeah, Kate, Detective Lockley.
So.
Oh, Cordy, stop helping.
Professional relationship then. He cares for her.
But, okay, oh, yeah. This is why I think whenever we discover a new piece of information, including in Buffy, like Buffy found out that Riley was one of the commandos and didn't tell everyone. I think whenever a new piece of information is discovered, we tell everybody. I don't care if you gotta go drive to Cordy's house. You tell her so she knows what to look out for. They also have cell phones now. So he could have texted her or whatever, or called her and been like, hey, this guy, this description, do not let him in. Do not answer his questions or whatever. But like, we need to keep each other informed. It's a problem in both shows for the characters.
More than he knows, but that's our angel. Dour, sure, but not afraid to get personally involved in his work. And you're totally pumping me for information, aren't you?
She figured it out.
Well.
Ooh.
Look who's back from his up with people meeting. What? You don't drink, so now no one gets to?
I don't expect you to understand.
Oh, I understand, Gleek. You just wake up one morning and decide, okay.
No, we got a spell. It's a whole thing.
No, Angelus, it doesn't end. It never, ever ends. It just goes on.
Try cheesy hack.
Ooh, get fucked.
You've been getting back at
your and your bad hairstyle.
It's pathetic and cliched. Probably got a killer shrine on your wall.
Uh-oh.
Nothing on the streets about a new vampire in town.
Right. See? And...
Just maybe because he's here and has me by the throat.
Let him go. No.
Just think of the worst possible thing you can imagine. I'll see you there.
He is not a vibe. But I do, I think I was saying before it crashed that, like, serial killers tend to get stuck in their pattern, so I'm surprised he's gonna be able to break it. At least Kate's doing her research.
Fun fact.
Hey man, Nade, you don't know about the gypsy spell. It's a whole thing.
I looked it up. It's all right there. The demon with the face of an angel. You made him, didn't you?
Well, technically.
Let me help end it, please.
But like Angel with a Soul didn't do it. I imagine you heard quite a lot in your and I see them as separate characters.
Ah, here it is. Los Angeles Globe, 1929. What are we looking for exactly?
I don't know yet.
1963, police tracked the killer to a residential hotel called the Cloverwood Apartments.
It's the same place. New name. Yeah,
you can do it again.
Not the first time that's happened in this town.
Huh, good old predictable pen.
That's fair. Like, if other vampires could do that, it'd be a little OP. No, I think it's pretty clear he's gonna go after Kate. That's why he was fishing for that info. Oh, no, we're not. Unless he left that as, like, to trick them, right? To make them think he's going after the kids. Oh no, he's here. Uh-oh. Damn it.
We're in.
I don't understand.
He's here.
First, I thought I'd stop everything and tell you my plan.
He does seem like a guy who likes to hear himself talk.
Why don't I just show you?
Angel, hurry the fuck up. Ew. Sniffing people is weirdo behavior. As he's a serial killer.
Bus full of school children, Pen.
I think I'm an idiot. Fall for that?
Well, you could have.
Nah. Too original.
But I've come to realize something. It's you.
I thought you were going to be like, you're my brother. You taught me! Stake him, Kate! Also, why is Angel suddenly unable to fight?
My mortal father never did! You're my real father, Angelus.
Fine!
Okay, stab him or run, but laying is not helping. Not for you.
And it sickens me to think that there was a time you would have done whatever was necessary.
No, thank you. Oh, she went low. Okay, okay. Gross. But now the police are gonna think he got away. She's like, I'm still your friend.
If you're wondering why this vein on my temple is doing the cha-cha, it's because I just had one of those bone-crunching, mind-splitting vision headaches.
I was just thinking about how much this place is like where I grew up.
Right.
I wonder if anything ever really changes.
Sure it does. They do. You have.
It's still in me, Cordelia.
Sure it's in you. We all have something, but it's not the only thing that's in you. You're not him, Angel. Not anymore.
My besties.
Sometimes they change back. If the day ever comes that I...
Oh, I'll kill you dead.
Yeah, Cordy, I love her, but she'll do what needs to be done. She saw what you were like. We ain't going back to that. No, thank you. No, thank you. At least you wouldn't have that magic ring, remember? That would be bad. This was a great episode. One of my faves so far. I feel like the angel just keeps getting better. But I really like episodes where the problem relates to the characters in some way. So, like, the episode where the ghost was haunting Cordy, it wasn't just a stranger being haunted, it was one of our characters. In this one, this is a consequence that Angel is facing because of who he was as Angelus. He, like, created this guy as a vampire, and he, like, trained him to be just like him, and then, you know, probably forgot about him in the state of getting his soul back and everything going on was kind of crazy, but it's like you made this monster and let it loose, and like obviously it's gonna come down to you to end it. And we saw he was willing. He was like trying to convey to Kate to like kill us both, like if you have to kill me to kill him, do it. Kate obviously was like, actually I'm a geometry genius, and went upwards into the shorter man, which worked. I think, yeah, the serial killer episodes are interesting. I think, God, I got a little of that true crime bug in me. I do like documentaries and stuff. So I'm like, ooh, they gotta find who the serial killer is and what the motive is. And I enjoy that. Like, Criminal Minds is one of my favorite series, despite me knowing it's not realistic at all. But it's fun. It's just a fun show. And this one is kind of in that same vein, but a little more crazy with some fantasy and a little more humor, which I really enjoy. I think Wesley was good this episode. I love that he was automatically like, Angel did it. And Cordy was like, he would never. And Angel's like, I think I did it. And she's like, cut his head off. I think Cordy is a good ally/friend for Angel, because she's nice, but she doesn't baby him, right? She's very, like, she's fiercely loyal and she cares, but, like, if she thought he was going back to being evil, she 100%, she'd be like, well, I have to do what I have to do. Because I know my friend Angel would not want to go back to that. I think they bounce off each other well. I think the actors have great chemistry. I think it's nice for them to have a third in, like, Doyle or Wesley, but I think, honestly, the two of them could carry a show. Like, they just give very great, like, every scene they're in, I'm like, I believe these characters are real and they're interacting. And that could just because they're two of my favorites, so I'm like, ooh, I'm getting my favorites. But, like, that ending scene felt like a scene from Spider-Man or Batman or something where the love interest is talking to Angel. But, obviously, I think Kate's his love interest, not Cordy. Though, I mean, would I complain if my two favorite characters had some romantic tension? No. I'd be okay with that, but, you know, it doesn't seem we're getting that because they were trying to pair Cordy with Doyle and him with Kate and then maybe her with Wesley. I don't know. But it is interesting. Really loved this episode. We'll be doing another Angel episode next time if you'd like to watch it early. It is already up on Patreon. But if not, I will see you on either Tuesday or Saturday, depending on when this comes out. I think this is coming out on Saturday, so I should see you Tuesday. So I will see you next time.